In this video, we will learn how to grow 6 to 8 kgs of tomatoes per plant grown in a container. Someone like you, I want you to know me, cause I know then you'll see. We can be true, we can be true. I want you to see what I see in us, something so real, something so real. Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Urban Gardening. Take some fresh organic tomatoes and cut them into slices. These are the seeds. Take a small pot with drainage holes at the bottom. Fill it with the soil mix. You can use seed starting mix to start your seeds, or just mix 60% garden soil and 40% compost. Place the slices on the potting mix surface. Now cover them with a fine layer of same soil mix. Water well. Now keep the pot in partial shade, and when the seed starts to germinate, move the pot into full sun or under grow lights. When the seedlings are 6 to 8 inches long, at that point you can transplant them at their final location. For the potting mix, use well-drained soil with good amount of organic matter, as tomato plants require fertile soil for good harvest. For that, take a mix of 60% garden soil and 40% organic compost. Choose a container or poly bag that is at least 18 to 20 inches in diameter and 15 to 18 inches deep. The bigger the better. Fill the bag with the potting mix. Make sure it has holes for drainage. You can order your smart grow bags now. Details are on the screen and in the description box down below. With the help of a trowel, take the plants out from the seedling pot. Make sure you do not disturb the roots during the transplanting process. Keep the root ball intact to avoid any heavy transplant shock. Dig a hole about 6 to 8 inches deep. Remove any lower leaves from the seedling and plant the seedling as deep as possible, because they actually have the ability to sprout additional roots along the buried stem. These extra roots will strengthen the plant so that it can support more fruit. Fill in the hole with the soil. Only the top few inches of the plant should be above the soil. In containers, keep at least 6 to 8 inch gap between two plants, and in ground, gap must be of 1.5 to 2 feet. Cover with soil and pat down lightly. Water well. Throughout the growing season, continue to water thoroughly whenever the top inch of the soil is dry. After transplanting, keep the bag in partial shade for 2 days. Let the plants recover from transplant shock, and after that, gradually expose the plants to the sun. Tomato plants need between 5 to 8 hours of direct sunlight per day in order to grow and eventually produce fruit. Water at least once a day to keep the top layer of the soil evenly moist. As tomato plants grow, you need to provide some support to the plants. For that, take long sticks, at least 4 to 5 feet tall, and insert them in the soil. Install wood sticks or sticks at least 4 to 5 feet tall. Tie the stems loosely to them with twine or strips of fabric. While tomato flowers are typically pollinated by wind and occasionally by bees, but the lack of air movement or low insect number can slow down the natural pollination process. In these situations, you may need to hand pollinate your tomato flowers. For that, simply shake the flower gently to distribute the pollen grains. Tomato plant will usually produce fruit between 35 to 60 days post-planting. After every 18 to 20 days, add organic compost in the soil as it will give your plants an extra boost to grow lots of tomatoes. The key to tomato success is to give your tomato plants a consistent amount of water. Keep the soil moist, not wet. Too much water and your plants' roots will rot. Too little water and your plants will get weak. Make sure to water the soil, not the foliage, as wet leaves can encourage diseases and fungus. After every 6 to 8 days, spray the plants with homemade organic pesticide made from neem oil, garlic extract and chili extract to keep the pests and insects away. As the tomatoes grow bigger and heavier, provide extra support to the stems. As tomato becomes ripe, grasp the fruit with your hand and gently pull from the stem. Harvest your tomatoes once they start turning red and ripe. Sharp scissors can be used to snip the tomatoes off from the branches. A fully ripe tomato will be softer than the unripe ones. Before you eat tomatoes that you harvest, wash them thoroughly with water. This will help to remove any fertilizer residue, dirt or bacteria. Before you eat tomatoes that you harvest, wash them thoroughly with water. This will help to remove any fertilizer residue, dirt or bacteria.